victory over one, Jose Valenzuela. But the man of the hour in the main event of the evening, coming out before the hometown fans here in Los Angeles, the former unified heavyweight champion of the world, three knockdowns en route to a unanimous decision victory over Luis King Kong Ortiz. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the victorious, the destroyer, Andy Ruiz Jr. Andy, give me your thoughts. How are you feeling? What a moment, what energy, what an atmosphere here tonight. What are your thoughts?
Man, I just want to give God all the glory, man, because without him, I wouldn't have won this victory. It was a hell of a fight, man. It was tough. That guy's hella tough, man, but I had to be smart. I had to be cautious. I was waiting a little bit too much to counterpunch. I felt when I had him hurt, I should have started throwing more combinations, but like I said, he hits hard, so I had to be more cautious and wait until I could counterpunch good.
If you have questions from the media, by all means, raise your hand and wait for Sam Jackson, one of our esteemed publicists, along with Kelly Swanson, to ask the question and give us your media platform. Go ahead, Steve.
Steve Moreno, KOR Sports. Congratulations, Andy. It was a great victory. You were moving to your right a lot into his left hand, but I felt like when you went forward is when you had a lot of success catching him and dropping him and things like that. Why was he making you go to his left, or was that part of the strategy to move to?
The strategy was trying to go to the right and to the left, trying to confuse him a bit, feigning him. That's why it took him a long time for him to load up, because he knew that I was going to counterpunch too. So the more I moved to the left, to my left, he would counter. So I started moving to the right, and that's when I started countering, and I was waiting for him to throw the left hand so I could throw my right hand, and it worked beautifully.
Andy, first of all, man, congratulations on your victory. How satisfied are you? What would you give your performance? What grade would you give it?
I think I'll give it a B, man, because I did feel a little off the distance, and you know, I was coming out of a year layoff, so I thought I did pretty good, especially fighting a veteran, a strong veteran that hits hard, and he was pretty smart, you know. And then my first time fighting a lefty, and a lot of people were saying, he was actually saying that he was gonna knock me down and all that, but he didn't even do that one time. And I just thank God that I got to drop him, and I couldn't close the TKO or anything like that, but I got the victory like I told everybody.
Andy, qué gusto saludarte. La primera pregunta, creo que es el peleador que más te ha exigido en tu carrera. ¿Estás de acuerdo conmigo?
Sí, claro que sí, porque era un estilo diferente. Era mi primera vez peleando con un zurdo y la neta yo pensaba que hicimos bien, pero podía hacer más y podía acabar la pelea. Pero estaba cuidado, estaba pensando de más, pero como le dije, agarré la victoria y gracias a Dios.
Mensaje para México, por favor, Andy Ruiz. Mensaje para México, que estuvo paralizado. Dicen que no había perros en las calles.
Claro que sí, man. Gracias a Dios que agarramos la victoria. Y yo quiero ser campeón del mundo otra vez. Y por eso entrenamos duro para esta pelea. Triunfamos bien. Yo sé que era una pelea dura, pero agarramos la victoria. Gracias a Dios.
There were two questions in there by Ernesto. The first one was about the difficulty of the fight. And you know, he was softball, and he made me fight really hard. I had to adjust. I had to make counters, but I ended up coming out on top. And my message to Mexicans out there is that I thank them very much. Thank you for your support. It was a hard fought victory, and I'm very thankful with all of you.
Andy, primeramente felicidades por el triunfo.
Hold on, guys. If you wait for the mic, and then by all means.
Andy, aquí Gonzalo Alvarado de CNN en español. Felicidades. Andy, en el segundo y séptimo round, mirábamos que ya tenías la victoria, ahora sí, ya en los guantes, básicamente. En la conferencia de prensa que dices previo a la pelea, decías que no iban a llegar al doceavo round, que se iba a definir quizás antes del doceavo round. En el segundo round, tenías todos los elementos ahí para doblegarlo y llevarte la victoria. ¿Qué pasó ahí? ¿Por qué no hubo esa definición completa?
Pues yo no pensé que todavía estaba muy golpeado. Yo sé que lo tumbé, pero todavía tenía que estar cuidado, tenía que estar inteligente, y él es un veterano y contragolpea bien. So, todavía me quedé contento, me quedé en paz y chiquito, y pues esperaba por el otro counter. Y gracias a Dios que agarramos el otro counter, lo tumbamos, pero como les dije, todo, a todos iba a agarrar la victoria, si era knockout o los 12 rounds.
Well, like I always said, it was going to be either the knockout or 12 rounds. Either way, I was going to come out with a win. That's what I did, right? So, in a way, in that second round that you mentioned, as far as the question was, if Andy thought that he had Ortiz in his grasp in that second round when he knocked him down, and there were a couple of counter moves that I felt that were very effective, and I thought that was a great round for me, but I also knew that I had to be cautious, that it wasn't over by any stretch of the imagination, and that in a way that allowed me to continue being strong throughout the fight. Next question.
Andy, back here. Marcus Hayes, Fight Hub TV. First, congratulations on your victory tonight. Well fought, Andy. You and Ortiz both. Andy, after the fight, I met up and talked to Deontay Wilder. Deontay Wilder said basically that he was recognizing that all roads look like they're leading to you and him locking arms, and he welcomes the challenge. How open are you to fighting Deontay Wilder? Will you be cheering for him on the 15th?
Of course, man. That's one of the dream fights that I always had, just like Ortiz, and it's just another step closer to get that WBC belt that I've always been praying and wishing for. And you know, thanks to God, we got this victory. Hopefully, he gets his victory in October, and we can make this fight happen. He's under Al Haymon just like me, so it's a fight where it could be easily made. And I'm ready, man. I want to stay busy. I want to go straight to the gym again because, like I said, I didn't feel at my 100%, but we got the victory.
Andy, primeramente,
wait for the mic.
Eso iba a preguntarte, Andy, aquí Saúl Rodríguez de Telemundo. Ahora, después de esta victoria, aquí, ¿qué sigue después de esta victoria?
Pues gracias a Dios que agarramos la victoria y para atrás para el gimnasio, porque necesito más, pues a tener más, porque sí duré un rato sin pelear y lo sentí eso, pero como dije, agarré la victoria y pues ya estamos listos para buscar otro rival, si es el Wilder o si es alguien más. Nomás quiero estar ocupado y pues estar peleando más.
The question was, what's next for you after this win? And Andy was saying, hey, it's back to the gym for me because I felt rusty after, you know, during this fight, after not having fought for a while. I know I need to be more active. That's the goal. So here I come. I'm gonna be more active from now on. And whoever comes next, Wilder or the opponent of choice, then I'm gonna be ready for whoever comes my way.
Felicidades. Dos preguntas. La primera, ¿cuál para ti fue la clave para esta victoria? Y la segunda, dijiste previo a la pelea que veríamos otra vez a ese Andy que fue campeón contra Joshua. ¿Te sentiste de esa manera arriba del ring?
Sí, yo creo que traje el gordito power otra vez. Hice lo mejor para ganar esta pelea. Era fuerte, sí me pegó con unos buenos troncazos, pero gracias a Dios que los recibí bien. Por el peso yo creo que tenía y me sentí explosivo y estaba esperando que él se abriera. So, me esperé que él tiraba y yo contragolpeara y así es como ganamos la pelea, a estar cuidado y paciente.
Well, it was definitely a tough fight. I felt that I was explosive, but Ortiz also, you know, he took some hard punches. I took some hard punches. Unfortunately, I was able to withstand. So in the end, it was just a very hard fight for both of us.
Andy, felicidades y tu victoria. ¿Cómo te sentiste en el ring después de no pelear por tanto tiempo? ¿Cómo te sentiste? Pues me sentí un poco afuera de la distancia por un año y algo sin pelear, pero hice todo lo que hicimos en el gimnasio, en el sparring. Teníamos un campamento de 4 meses y hice todo lo que dijeron mi esquina, el capatío, el Osuna, mi papá, y logramos esa victoria. Pero era difícil, no estoy diciendo que era fácil o nada, tenía que pensar mucho, tenía que estar en cuidado, porque es un veterano que sí pega duro, si miras mi ojo, pega duro. Pero hice todo lo posible para ganar esa victoria.
I did everything in my power to earn this win. The question was what the key was for that victory, and like I said before, I felt rusty. I knew that the lack of activity in the last year and a half was gonna be tough for me, but just look at my eye. He's a very big puncher, and I was able to withstand his power. That was the biggest thing. And thanks to Alfredo Osuna, to my dad, to everyone that supported me during my training, I was able to come out on top tonight.
Andy, primeramente felicidades por la victoria, una gran victoria. Quería preguntarte, recuerdo en el 2019 pesaste 268 libras en tu primera, en esa gran sorpresa contra Anthony Joshua. Hoy también, para esta pelea, estuviste en las 268 libras. Hazme una comparación en esas 268 libras de hoy a las de Anthony Joshua en la primera pelea. Y como segunda pregunta, si a partir de ahora, cuando vayas al ring, sería un error estar en las 250 aproximadamente.
No, pues yo me sentí bien a estar en las 268 libras, pero era diferente. Cuando yo peleé con Anthony Joshua primero, ya peleé eso, ya estaba listo para la pelea, porque ya estaba peleando cada tres meses, o ya estaba listo, y en esta pelea era diferente. Por eso me quería poner a la 268 igual, para estar fuerte, para estar rápido y a recibir esos golpes, porque los bombazos sí están fuertes de los pesos pesados. Pero no, yo creo que me sentí bien y no creo que voy a cambiar nada, nomás a trabajar más en el gimnasio y a pelear más, porque sí me sentía fuera de la distancia.
The question was about how he felt weight-wise now compared to the Joshua fight. And Andy was saying that the difference, the biggest key that there was between now and then was that back then against Joshua, I had been fighting every 3 months. I felt ready, I felt sharp. Not this time around. So I wanted to put on that weight so I could be able to withstand those big shots that come in the heavyweight division. And I felt really good. I feel no need to change anything up in the future going forward.
I reached out to behind the gloves. You said that Ortiz hit harder. Who hit harder, Joshua or Ortiz?
I think they both hit hard, man. I think Anthony Joshua caught me when I didn't see a punch, and I think he put me down like that. But with Luis Ortiz, I was cautious. I was looking at all the punches that he would hit me. So there's a punch that he got me good, and I just seen it straight coming, boom, boom, and I was like, damn. And but they all hit hard, man. They all fucking hit hard. And I feel the advantage that I took that punch well was because of the weight that I had on. I think if I would have been at 250-something, I think he would have dropped me. And it would have been a fight of me getting dropped and me dropping him. But I felt strong, I felt explosive, and I was being a little too cautious because, well, he hits hard, you know, so I had to be smart.
One more.
Chris, UTV Boxeo. Andy, después de la pelea, Deontay Wilder se subió arriba del ring. ¿Eso te sorprendió? Y también, ¿qué fue lo que te dijo Deontay Wilder?
No, pues me felicitó, me dijo que buena pelea y... pero sí, me gustaría pelear con él. Si os quiere, él gana la victoria también en octubre contra Robert. Esa pelea se puede hacer fácil porque estamos con Al Haymon, los otros dos. So, si él quiere pelear conmigo, está bien. Porque es una pelea más cerca para yo agarro el WBC belt y quiero ser campeón del mundo otra vez. So, por eso quiero hacer todo lo posible para ser campeón del mundo y traer esos cinturones para atrás, para México. No los voy a dejar abajo, ya me voy a poner las pilas, la neta.
So, the question was, did it surprise you when Deontay Wilder came onto the ring, and what did he tell you? Deontay told me that I fought a good fight, that congratulations, and like I mentioned before, we're both under a Haymon, it's a fight that can definitely happen, but now I gotta get going, I gotta, you know, move and just be as ready as I can be because I want the WBC belt back. I need that world title. That's my ultimate goal, and that's what I'm aiming for from now on.
Last question right here.
Andy, Muhammad Mubarak with EURWeb.com. You've developed a huge fan base here in Southern California, and I see one of your biggest fans is sitting right next to you. How much of the cheering in the crowd affected you during the fight?
It didn't really affect me, man. I got my manager right here. But when we're walking down to the ring, there was a guy that fell in front of me. It was pretty crazy. And they had to push him away and all that. But I was just still focused, man. Still focused and just praying to God, please, God, give me this victory. And the whole time, throughout walking through that tunnel, I'm just praying and praying to get this victory. And just thinking about all the stuff that I did in the gym and just thinking, I gotta be smart, I gotta be cautious, I gotta be careful with his left hands or his overhooks. So I think we did a good plan. I think you guys seen something different than I usually do, come forward and throw combinations. I try to box around and counter punching. I counter punched a counter puncher because that's exactly how he wins the fights, and God willing, we got that victory.
All right, well, at this time, I want to give Andy the floor for final comments, but one half of the WBC heavyweight title eliminator is complete. Andy Ruiz victorious over Luis King Kong Ortiz, October 15th. You heard it, Deontay Wilder, Robert Hellenius on Fox Sports, BBC pay-per-view. Andy Ruiz, your final thoughts, and give it maybe over to your manager, however the case may be, to give your final thoughts on tonight's performance.
So while we were walking down the little thing, when the guy fell on, he hit my head and stuff hard.
You did?
Yeah, he did.
Damn.
You got a chin like your dad, I'll tell you that.
And I just wanted to say thanks to God that we got this victory and stuff. I was nervous and stuff, and yeah.
All right, congratulations, Andy Ruiz, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much to the media, thank you to the fans, and we will see you next month, October 15th, on Fox Sports BBC pay-per-view. Deontay Wilder, Robert Hellenius, but congratulations to Andy Ruiz Jr., ladies and gentlemen. Have a great rest of your Labor Day weekend.